Hey there, data gods and data goddesses. This is Chris Wagner. Welcome to Kratos BI. Today we're going to be going over how you create a Power BI data set and how you can leverage it inside of a report. All right, let's jump into it. Wow. Okay, so wait, hold on. Hang on a second. If you like this content, you want to see more of what I'm doing here, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and heck, why not even turn on that alarm bell so you get updated every time me or, you know, Mr. Wick here upload some additional content. You'll get that little push notification on your phone, and you'll just drop what you're doing and run on over, okay? It really helps support the channel and ensures I can keep making this content. Thanks, guys. Back to it. Okay. So here we are. Here's me and John. We've built out this Power BI report. This is awesome. Everybody loves it. This is the report that drives our company. People enjoy the crap of it. It's just great. The question is, they keep asking for more and more reports and more content to be built off of this report. And the reality is, I've kind of built in all of the navigation functionality that I can inside of this one report, and I need to start looking at how can I build off more reports off this same data set. I could just, you know, save this file as a new file, delete everything here, start you know, with all different tabs inside another Power BI file. But then what ends up happening is I get two different data files that are out inside the Power BI service. You know, one refreshes and is fine. The other one doesn't refresh and there's a lag. And then people getting this question like, hey, these numbers are off. How can we get them to be right? So let's not do that. Let's instead use the data model that's inside of this Power BI report that we know, that we love, and you know, we've been working on this for years, that we want to share with other people. Let's turn this into a data set so that people can leverage this. So I'm going to show you how to do that. All right, first step, create a new tab for you that you're going to basically change the background on, and you're going to change it to black, and you're going to insert a text box. And you're going to say, data set only. You're going to go down here. You're going to change it to white. You're going to go and change the font to like 42. Space that out. Drag that into the middle of your guy. Turn off your border. Turn off your visual head. And have this as your page. So we're going to add that. We're going to call this data set. And then we're going to, rewind. Step one is file, save as, Kratos BI. I'll make sure I'm in the right place now. Dun, 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 dun. And we're going to Kratos BI, data set. I'll put a little underscore underneath that guy. We'll click on save. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through and I'm going to delete all of the content that is in here. Right? I don't want any of it. We're getting down. We're eliminating everything that's inside here. Right? So we're going to delete it all. Oops. Delete it. Delete this one too. Delete. 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 All right. So I'm down to my data set. I'm going to save this guy. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to make sure I'm signed into the Power BI service up here. So I'll zoom in so you can see where I'm looking. All right, so right up here, I could see that my name is signed in right here. So I am good to go. So I'm going to publish this out to the service. I'm going to save and publish. I saved it. I'm going to click on publish. It's going to ask me where do I want it to go. I'm going to make sure that I've saved it out into my datasets and data flows workspace. I'm going to click on select. It's going to start publishing this out to Power BI. As soon as this gets done, I'm going to get the big thumbs up. It's going to ask me if I want to go out there and browse it. I am. And then I'm going to go out and check it out there. And then I am going to either, I'm going to go in and I'm going to certify this data set that this is the data set that I want people to use. So hang on as it gets out there. Wait for it. Success. So I'm going to open up my Power BI desktop. It's going to, of course, launch another browser. I can see that. But when I go out to my... Okay, no. Oh, look at this. Begin a survey that I can't opt out of. Oh, okay. I can't. Power BI, you almost got me there. Okay, so I've got this up. I've got, and I realized, you know, hey, I do have my certified data set. This is out there. I'm going to call this guy my promoted data set so that I can know that I can make changes to this before I promote it up into the Kairos BI data set. So I'm just going to call this as settings. I'm going to go in. I'm going to change my endorsement. I'm just going to go to promoted. It's not certified. It's not ratified. This is my promoted data set for my development and testing, right? So I'm going to click on apply. And then when I go back into my workspace, I'm going to see that this data set now has promoted off of it. All right, awesome. Now I have that data set that's out there. It's inside the service. I got it. I'm good to go. So now I can close this guy out. And yeah, save. Why twice? I already saved it once. Doesn't need it again. Who knows? All right. So now I want to make a report off of that. Better, I want to make the same report off of that. Now, there's going to be some like gotchas around this one, and I'm going to go over what the gotchas are just so that you're aware of them. All right, so I'm going to go back into that original PBIX file. I'm going to open that guy up. This is, again, the guy I know and love. It's connected to the data sets. You can see that it's got the, cancel. It's got the mod, or it's got the data view. It's got the model view. Now, in the June release, you'll see the model view if you're connected to a data set. Now you can tell if you're working with the data or not, if it has the data tab or not. But so I've got this guy, right, that I want to convert over to use that new data set that I publish out in the service. So I'm going to drag this off to another monitor for now, and I'm going to fire up another copy of Power BI. Okay, while that's going on, I'm going to do a little plug so that we can forget about this later. If you like the content that I'm putting out, go to the kairosbi.com, buy me a coffee. I'll send you some of these great stickers that I got. I got the new I Love Power BI stickers available for us. If you like the merchandise, you want to, you know, I got tons of like gut data guides, the guys' t-shirts, hit the links below. Go out. All of this fun's going to help support the channel, like get that new key light that I just got installed and my wife is shaking her head about. The you can kind of see it, like when I do this now, you see a big circle there. But go ahead, go out, support the channel. I guarantee, I think every penny that comes in into new content and new material that's going out, back to it. Okay, Power BI is back up. So I've got a new file. This is good. So I've got my original Power BI desktop file open, and I've got Power BI open. Now I want to go in and I want to connect to the Power BI datasets that's out there. So I'm going to click on Power BI datasets. Does Control Z do it? No, how about Windows Z? Somewhere I have a hotkey for Zoom. Zoom. All right, so you can see if I click on Power BI datasets, this window pops up. Now there's two data sets that's available to me. There's my certified one that was out and published out in the service. And there's the data set that I just published that's out there. So I'm going to choose on the data set. All right, so I'm going to click on this guy, click on create. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run through and I'm going to recreate the visuals that I had in my other Power BI inside this Power BI. Now, in many ways, this is very simple. So I'm going to go over to this Power BI. I'm going to click on Control A. It selects everything. Control C. And then I'm going to come over to this new Power BI and click Control V. I'm going to paste it all over here. Come on. Control V. There we go. Okay, so everything comes flying over. We notice some differences here. Like, I don't have my page background in place. So I'm going to add in one. Where did it go? Crash BI, Power BI backgrounds. Bum, 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 bum. Change it to 0 and then fit. And then I am good to go. What happened here? Oh, okay. So this has a background. Turn that off. All right, so basically I've finished this guy off. So this guy, I'm going to make sure that has the same name as what's here. So I'll call this guy home. Right, and now what I'm going to do is I'm basically going, and I'm, before I forget, I'm going to go out and I'm going to import in Browse for Themes. I'm going to import in my Kratos BI theme. Where is it? Themes. Where the hell is my themes? Kratos BI themes. Here we go. Boom. Import my Kratos BI theme. Everything comes flying in. So now I've got my colors look. My look and feel of everything is identical. So I'm good to go there. Now there's some things I want to call out here that's going to be different that I'm going to have to pay attention to. Now the actions, like specifically on each of these items, I'm going to have to make sure that I go through and I remap these. Now, when this Kratos BI file was built, if I went over here, clicked on actions, I'm gonna go down here. I'm gonna see that was a bookmark type and I had a bookmark for the home page, right? One of the things that does not come through in the copy paste is all of your bookmarks. So while you do save a ton of time in bringing it over, you don't have to recreate every visual, line it all up. I mean, you could see, it came over and it looks just right, right? But I'm going to have to go through and I'm going to have to put in, the bookmarks back in. It's kind of okay. All of this does really, I don't have any bookmarks that mark the state of any page inside this report. All I'm doing is navigating, and now there's that new navigation function, so it does make it much easier. But that is the process that you then have to go through in order to create your report. But the benefit is, now I only have one data set that's out in Power BI. I can still go into here. I can see all of the tables, understand what's going on inside the model, and I can build out my new report using that one, sample data set. And I can actually then build out as many reports as I want off this. Again, solving that initial question that people had. So to recap, first thing first, have your curated golden data set or that golden data set that you want to make and get ready for for other people, right? Step two, create just a PBX file that you're going to be using to manage the data set, right? That was that first item that I did, right? Step three is publish out to the service. And then step four is build reports pointed off of that new data set. All right. Thanks everybody very much for watching this stuff. Remember, like, subscribe, turn on that alarm bell. Really appreciate everything that you guys have done. Really enjoying this stuff. If you have any ideas for additional videos, you want me to talk about different things, or you want to appear in one of the Q&A sessions I've been doing, put in the comments below, send me a message, let me know what's on your mind. I'm happy to talk about it. I have a great deal of experience inside this space, and I talk with and work with people on the Power BI team on a at least weekly basis. So happy to hear what you're looking for, and I can probably point you in the right directions on solutions, or give you a heads up on the direction of the platform and stuff. So as always, thanks everybody. Peace.